Do you operate physical stores along with online stores? Want a point of sale system to manage both your physical stores and online stores easily? Well, here we are with a useful point of sale plugin for your WooCommerce store. Hey guys, I'm Satyam this side, and today we'll be going through the WooCommerce point of sale system plugin. The point of sale system lets the admin create multiple outlets for the online store and assign them sales agents. The POS agent can easily manage the sales and customers of the assigned outlet using the various options provided in the POS system. We'll also see how the POS works in online and offline modes both. Now, let's check the working of the plugin. But before that, please don't forget to click on the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates from us. Apart from this, I would like to mention that if you need extensions for increasing the sales of your e-commerce store, then you can visit store.webkul.com and explore a number of products for every technology. We also have the user guide for the same in our blog sections, from where you can check the features and configurations to get to know the functionality of the extensions as well. Now, let's move back to our video. All right, now let's check the working of the WooCommerce point of sale system from the front end. So here we are on the front end point of sale. So here we are going to log in to the point of sale as an agent. Now let's log in. Now, after we log in, we'll have to enter an opening amount for the cash draw. Either I can input an amount or I can click on later as well. I'll input an opening amount for the cash draw. I'll input 1000. Now let's click on OK. All right, so that's done. So here we are on the storefront, which is the main homepage of the POS panel. So I'll explain to you the options available here, and then we'll quickly move on to see the settings that are available in the side panel as well. And then we'll also place an order while being online and offline. So now let's check the front page, which is the home page. So on the home page here, we have on the top, we have the categories listed, which is the all clothing, decor, music, and uncategorized, in which the product will be listed accordingly. So in the all, we have all of the products that have been listed for the POS from the backend available here. So here we have different products, and we have products available and listed as per the categories as well. So if we have music, we have uncategorized products as well. All right, I'll quickly show you the other options available as well. So on the top right, we have the option to enable a dark mode as well. The POS panel works in the light mode and dark modes both. So if I click on the moon icon, it turns into dark mode. So in the next option, we have a shortcut to go to the offline sale or orders. So once I click on that, it will directly move me to the offline sale or orders. In the next option, we have a Wi-Fi icon, basically a network icon, which will show if my POS panel is currently online or offline. In the next option, we have a hold cart icon available. If I click on that, it will quickly redirect me to the hold sale option, which we'll talk about in the later part of the video. In the next one, we have keyboard shortcuts. If I click on that, it will open up the list of keyboard shortcuts that are available for the POS panel, and the sales agents can utilize them. So the last option shortcut that we have here is the expand screen. If I click on that, it will fully expand my screen, POS panel screen. All right. So now let's place an order as an example and see how the checkout process works. So I'll quickly add the product. We'll choose an option. I'll quickly click on add to cart. So here we have the cart visible on the right hand side of the POS panel. We have two options available here as well to apply, which is basically the coupon or the discount. And the next one, we have the display showing us the total, subtotal, the tax, and the grand total as well. And the next part we have, we'll have the hold cart and the pay option available as well. For now, we'll click on pay to see the full process. Now let's click on pay. So here on the next page, we have the order details and the amount to be that will be paid. Here we have the option to either the customer to pay through the cash payment or other payments as well. So on the, we'll click on the cash payment and we'll input the amount that is given by the customer. So here we'll input $200, and here we have confirm payment button is active now. So we'll quickly click on confirm payment and generate the invoice for this order. Great. So the order has been confirmed and successfully placed. So we have a print invoice button and a skip button available as well. So we'll quickly generate an invoice. So yeah, here as you can see, we have successfully placed the order and an invoice has been generated for the same. So that's the process for the online one. All right. So now I'll quickly shut off the internet and we'll see how the POS panel can work in offline mode as well. So now I'll quickly place an order in the offline mode as well. All right. So I've added the product to the cart. Now let's click on pay. All right. You can see in the offline mode, we are on the payment page as well. So now let's input a payment. So the confirm payment and generate invoice button has been activated as well. Let's click on that. So there you can see the success message. The order has been successfully placed. Now let's print an invoice in the offline mode as well. So there you go. A successful invoice has been generated in the offline mode and the order has been placed as well. Alright, now I'll quickly show you the offline order has been recorded in the offline setting as well. Let's go to orders and let's go to offline sale and orders section. So here we have the order ID, order date and the order total for the product that we placed in the offline mode as well. Further, we can also sync both the online and the offline orders with this sync orders button as well. Let me get back the internet and we'll check this button out. All right, now that the internet is back, you can see there the order has been synced and it is now present here in the sale history and the order has been synced. We have the sync orders available as well. All right. So that has been done. Now let's check the other sections as well. We have the customers. So basically this is the customers and the sales agent can create a customer as well by clicking on add customer. Here they can enter the following details, the customer name, the customer phone, the email and their address and save the customer. Basically they can see the other customer details as well from here. Now let's go to cashier. Here we have three sections available, which is basically the close counter, the today cash and the sale history. In the close counter, we have several details that are available. Basically the opening amount, the expected amount in drawer and the difference available. We can also see the payment modes, the cash and the grand total. And the remarks that will be input by the sales agent. The sales agent at the end of the working day can click on this close drawer button and the drawer will be closed successfully. Now in the today cash section, we have other details such as opening drawer amount, today cash sale and the today other payment sale available. Here we can see a breakdown on the basis of order ID, the time, the order total and the payment mode. Here in the sale history, we can see the sale history that has been done in the POS panel. Now let's check the order section. Here in the order section, you can see the sale history on the basis of the order ID and the order date total, channel and the order status, which are in the completed or the processing state. In the wholesale, we have basically, this is a function that, which I'll be talking about in a later part of the video. And this is the offline sale or order section, which I explained previously. Let's check the report section. Here in the report section, the sales agent can view the various reports that are available for the POS panel. You can see several charts will also be available for the sales agent to view and analyze. They can also filter these reports on the basis of several pre-built filters that are on the basis of products, revenue, orders, coupons, taxes, and can also set a date range for the same. They can also reset this reports by clicking on this reset button. Now let's go to settings. Here in the settings, we have all three sections available as well, which is basically the account settings, the other settings, and the keyboard shortcuts. Here in the account section, we have various details available, such as the first name, the last name, email, previous password, new password, and confirmed password. So basically, this section is for the sales agent to change their passwords and also change their profile images. In the other settings, we can select the invoice page size, which is basically when the invoice is generated, they can set the size of the page for the invoice to be printed on. In the next section, we have the keyboard shortcuts. This is basically the keyboard shortcuts that are available for the POS panel, using which the sales agent can navigate and utilize the POS. These are the options available. Now in the last one, we have the reset button available. This basically resets the POS panel. So now let's click on it to reset the panel. Now we have reset, and you saw in the pop-up that products were imported and the POS panel was reset. All right. Now let's check the hold cart functionality of the WooCommerce point of sale system. Now I'll click on a product and add it to the cart. Now suppose if a customer doesn't want to immediately buy this product, the sales agent can put the cart on hold. Now when the product is added into the cart, the sales agent will simply click on hold cart, and they can order, they can input a note here. Suppose the customer wants to buy it at after some time. Now I'll input a note here. Now I'll enter this note here, add order note here. All right. So basically, after the hold cart, the order and the products moves to the hold sales section in the orders tab. Here the note is available, and the product that was added and was held in the cart is available as well. Now the sales agent can either delete this or add more products into it. Now if we click on add, the product will be added to the cart, and the sales agent can add more products into the cart and proceed for the payment. So this is how the hold cart function works.
So there we have it, a comprehensive workflow of the WooCommerce point of sale plugin. If you require any further assistance or have more queries, please don't hesitate to reach out to us at support@webkul.com or raise a ticket at webkul.uvdesk.com. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, stay tuned.